All these are the work of one and the same Spirit, and he gives them to each one just as he determines. Amen. To speak about the first gift of verse 10. I don't know how it is in your translations, in the original Greek New Testament this gift is called like this. Actions of power. Actions of powers. Amen. My translation in English, it says miraculous powers. I don't know if it's the same meaning in the Sinhalese. Yes. Or in some Bibles you can find working of miracles. Now God wants you and me to work in the supernatural. And He wants to give you the gift of miraculous powers. We'll see the gift. We will see some examples and understand how the gift operates. And then we are going to ask the Holy Spirit to give us this gift. Because the gifts of the Holy Spirit were not only for the time of the apostles, but they are for today as well. We need these gifts and we must learn that God wants us to live in the supernatural as well as the natural. Amen. What is the gift of the miraculous powers? It's a supernatural demonstration of miracles, of things that are not natural. And the laws of nature change. That means you can do things that are impossible. God comes with power and He does something that is impossible. This is a miracle. So it's supernatural action from God through you. And it's a gift of power. Let me give you an example to understand it. One day Jesus was ministering to many, many people. Now remember, Jesus is God, but He became man like us. And he was filled with the Holy Spirit, like God wants to fill us up. And he ministered in the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And Jesus is our example. So we must learn to behave and move like Jesus. So Jesus was ministering to many, many people. Evening came. They were far out of the nearest village. People got hungry. And let's see what happened. Let's go to the Gospel of Matthew chapter 14. Matthew 14, and we're going to read from verse 19. Matthew 14, 19 until 21. Okay, Jesus is speaking and he says, and he directed the people to sit down on the grass, taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, and looking up to heaven, he gave thanks and broke the loaves. Then he gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the people. Can you read that first verse 19? Let's understand this. Jesus took 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. He prayed. And then he started giving to his disciples to give to the people. Now, how many people do you think can eat from 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish? I think 20 is too much. Too many. Okay, let's see. Let's read verses 20 and 21. They all ate and were satisfied, and the disciples picked up 12 basketfuls of broken pieces that were left over. The number of those who ate was about 5,000 men, besides women and children. That is not natural. Jesus could feed 10, 15 people, but he fed more than 5,000 people. Besides the women and children, that means there were more than 5,000. That is the gift of miraculous powers in operation. So I believe you understand how we give, what is this gift. Now in the word of God, there are used many words for the word miracle. If we go to Acts 2:22, let us see, understand a little more before I go on. Acts, Kriya deke, visi deke, Acts 2:22.
Kriya deke, visi
deke. Here, Peter is speaking to the people. And he says, men of Israel, listen to this. Jesus of Nazareth was a man accredited by God to you by miracles, by powers, wonders, and signs which God did among you through him, as you yourselves know. Amen. There are three words that are used here for miracles. We can see them different times in the Bible. I don't know how they are translated in Sinhalese. But in the original language, it is powers, wonders, and signs. So let's start from the third one. A sign is something that shows towards someone. John, when he wrote his gospel, he put at the end, all these things were written and all these miracles that Jesus did took place as a sign to see that Jesus is God. It's a sign. The sign shows somewhere, shows somebody. So when a miracle takes place, it shows to Jesus. Because miracles happen in the name of Jesus. Amen. Let's go quickly to the second word. It is wonders. Wonder is something, it's an amazing miracle that people see and they are surprised. And they speak about it. So when God does something, people stay like this, huh? They don't believe it. They are amazed. That is the wonder. That is another reason of miracles. Amen. And the first word, in the original language, it's powers. In my translation, it says miracles. I don't know how it is in Sinhalese. Power. Okay, that's the right translation. A miracle shows the power of God. So God is doing miracles so people can see that He is the true God and there is power in Him. Amen. And we could see miracles in the life of Jesus. Then we can see miracles in the life of the apostles of Jesus, Petros, Johann, Peter, John.
Apostle Paul, Apostle
see other people of faith like Stephen or Philip. And then we read that in the churches, miracles were happening and there was no apostle there. No special person like Stephen or Philip. But it was just simple believers like you and me. Which means God is not using special people to have for a miracle, but He is using simple people like us. Amen. If you want a miracle, don't expect someone to come from America or from Sri Lanka or from India. But God wants to use you. Amen. Okay, what is the purpose of this gift of miraculous powers? First it shows that God of the gospel is the true God and the miracles prove it. The miracles show to people that your gospel about the salvation is Jesus is true.
Yes, once prakash kara once ke vachana sabha manushya pilikante ana me aashchar ke dakiti.
And many times God confirm your words by signs and wonders and miracles.
Unwanse jiva manava unwanse manushya lise pelun kara purva sah lakun kriya kar dene.
Amen. Another reason why God is using this gift
it's
because He wants to show His mercy and compassion to us. Our God is a good God that loves us and cares for us. But He also wants to show His mercy to every person. One day Jesus was invited at a wedding in the Cana of Galilee. And after the wedding service, they had a great party and all the city, all the town was invited. They were eating and drinking. But they ran out of wine. This was going to be a shame for the newlyweds. And people in the town were going to say bad words for them because they didn't take good care of their guests. But Jesus was there. So He showed mercy and compassion. He took 6 jars of water. And He turned it into wine. So there will be no problem with the new couple. So you see, He operated in the gift of miraculous powers, turning the water into wine,
උන්වහන්සේ ආශ්‍රය කිරීමේ බලය උන්වහන්සේ ස්ථානයේ වතුර ප්‍රජාය මිදෙන්නට බවට උන්වහන්සේ එක හැමින් සලසුවා.
And he did it out of mercy and compassion to these people.
උන්වහන්සේ දෙන උන්වහන්සේ තුමනා දයාව සහ අනුකම්පාව නිසායි.
Now remember that always the gift, this gift and all the gifts are for the glory of God. Not of the man that God is using. When God uses you for a miracle, the glory must not come to you, but you must give the glory to God. And you have to be careful when people come in the name of Jesus and do miracles, but they receive the glory. Be careful. That is not God's way. All glory must go to God. Amen. Amen. And the last reason, it is for the body of Christ to be built up, that God is giving this miracle.
And
many times there are obstacles or things that obstruct the work of God in his body, and God does miracles to overcome. One day Jesus was with his disciples in a boat in the sea. There was a great storm. And the boat was going to sink. But Jesus was in the boat. So the disciples woke him up. He stood up. And he said to the wind and the storm, "Be quiet." Immediately, the storm stopped and it was calm. You see, now this gift in operation controls the laws of nature. Amen. We need this gift. Okay, let's come to the difficult question. When God will give me this gift, how am I going to learn to operate the gift? Remember, the Holy Spirit wants to give you the gift. This gift of miraculous powers is for you. How can you operate it? It is simple. First, you hear from God. And then you obey and you do what God tells. But you must not be afraid that people will laugh at you, will mock you, because you are going to do something impossible. I will give you an example to understand. Let's go again to Matthew 14. Matthew 14. We are going to read verses 27 to 29.
අපි 27 සහ 27 සිට 29 දක්වා කියවට යනවා.
Okay. The disciples of Jesus are in a boat again.
Yes, once he goes in another boat with his name.
And Jesus is coming walking on the sea.
Yes, on the water. Yes, once he removed the water, that was the water of the fight at the Nirma.
Again, Jesus is operating using the gift of miraculous powers.
Nevertheless, Jesus was saying, "I shall give you my body. I will not give you my soul. I will not give you my life."
Have you ever tried to walk on the water? Have you been successful? Usually, when we put our foot on the water, we go down. Now Jesus was walking, not swimming, walking on the water.
Yes, was the being sitting there, was giant everything sitting.
And his disciples in the boat, they were afraid.
Yes, was the God on board was sitting on fire.
Let's go to verse 27. Matthew 14:27. But Jesus immediately said to them, "Take courage, it is I. Don't be afraid." Among of them was Peter. So Peter now speaks. "Lord, if it is you," Peter replied, "tell me to come to you on the water." Now, Peter said, "If Jesus can do it, I want to do it as well." Okay, now Peter wants to move in the gift of miraculous powers. So, go to verse 29. "Come," Jesus said. Now, remember, the gift operates like that. First, you hear God. And then you obey and take a step of faith. So now God is speaking now and says, "Come." Now, then Peter got down out of the boat, walked on the water, and came towards Jesus.
Amen.
So you can understand. First you hear what God says, and then you do the impossible. Now, overcome your fear that you may fail. And overcome your fear that people will mock you. When God tells you, obey and take a step of faith. And then you will see this gift operating. Amen. Let me give you another example. It is from Luke 5. One day Jesus was in the harbor where the boat of Peter was. And Jesus spoke to the people.
Yes,
Let us read Luke 5, 4 to 6. Luke 5, 4 to 6. When Jesus finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and let down the nets for a catch." Again, God is speaking. Jesus is speaking. Then Simon Peter answers. Simon answered, "Master, we have worked hard all night and haven't caught anything. But because you say so, I will let down the nets."
Simon uttardevi, Swami apuratriyam vesirvam, namu mukavat alvenyata, et obave vachini nisa, that elami kiveya.
Amen. Let's see what Peter says.
Obavaran makhetuski mesangatokime.
But because you say so, I will do it.
Et mesan ketuski obakienamanam, mama ete karanam.
Let us say together. But because you say so, I will do it. Let us say it again. Amen. Because Jesus says it, I will do it. That's how the gift operates. And look what happened. Let's go to verse 6. When they had done so, they caught such a large number of fish that their nets began to break. Amen. That is how the gift operates. I'm reminded something that happened last year. Last year, I went into a house for a prayer meeting. It was summer. And the refrigerator of the people in the house was broken about 2-3 days before. So after the prayer meeting, as a good pastor, I thought to help them to see if we can fix the refrigerator. As my profession is electrical engineers, I knew a little about how the refrigerator works. So we check the fuse, I check the wire, I check the compressor. We tried 3-4 times to make it work, nothing. So I told them, "Sorry, start from tomorrow to look to find another refrigerator." And as I was leaving from the house, God spoke to me. "Why don't you pray for the refrigerator to be
fixed?"
Well, as you laughed, I laughed also. But as I said, if you want to operate in this gift, you must not be afraid that people will laugh at you. So I told to the people in the house that were there for the meeting, "Let us pray for the refrigerator." They laughed as well. Anyway, we prayed and I said, "In the name of Jesus, be fixed." And of course, nothing happened. And who wanted me. I'm going home now. And I say good night to everybody. And I was driving home. And as I was driving, my mobile rang. It was from the people that had the house. The refrigerator started working. Amen. That's the gift of miraculous powers. God can do the impossible. Maybe it's funny, but God can do it because He shows love and mercy and compassion. Amen. So first you hear God speaking, then you obey and take a step of faith.
Amen.
Amen. Okay. Let's clear one or two more things before we pray. Now, can a person that has this gift do miracles whenever he likes? The answer is no. It is God who decides about the miracle and it's not the man. Even if I go out and find all the refrigerators, I cannot tell them to start working because they will not stop. If you try to go to the sea and start walking on the sea, you will not walk. Or if you take the bread and you start breaking it, it will not feed 5,000 people. Amen. You see, even there, Jesus, if you have noticed, first He prayed, He gave the word of God, and then He did what He told Him, and then that will happen. Amen. This gift is not under your control, it is under God's control. Amen. Okay. And there is another question that many people ask. Pastor, let's have more miracles so more people will believe in Jesus. At the time of Jesus, the Jews saw many miracles, but very few believed. Even other times they told Him, come and do miracle. Jesus said, no, you have seen enough. Even in this church we have seen many people seeing miracles, experience miracles. Nevertheless, they did not believe and they did not follow Jesus. The miracles can help, but don't think because there are miracles, people will believe in Jesus. Jesus did this miracle of multiplying the bread and the fish. And all these thousands of people saw the miracle. And the next day, when He preached something that they didn't like, they all left Him. Only His disciples stayed. So the miracle can help, but the miracle alone cannot make someone believe unless the Holy Spirit speaks in the heart. Amen. Do you believe that we need this gift of miraculous powers?
Yes.
Yes. Yes. We need miracles today. Let me close with this verse. John 14:12. Jesus is speaking to us. John 14:12. Jesus is speaking and he says, I tell you the truth. Anyone who has faith in me will do what I have been doing, and he will do even greater things than this. Amen. Jesus says, anyone who believes in me,
Do you believe in Jesus? Yes.
So Jesus says, the things I have done, you will do. And you will do greater things. Amen.
Amen.
So we need the power of the Holy Spirit to do these things. Let us pray for it. Amen. Let us pray. So in the name of Jesus, we ask this gift to give us. Your church, Lord, needs a gift. Give it to us in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Amen.
Open your mouth and you ask for yourself. Help us to live in the supernatural, in the power of the Holy Spirit. We commit ourselves again to you. And Lord, in a humble way, we ask you, give us your gifts. In the name of Jesus.
Yes,
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you. have your spiritual ears open, because God first speaks and then you obey and take the step.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Thank you. Amen.